Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO of Platinex, Greg Ferron. Greg, thank you for joining me.
Hi, Natalie. Nice to be here. Good morning.
Hello. And Greg, it's been a little while, so let's give a little refresher on what Platinex is all about and the exploration niche in Ontario that it's carving out.
Yeah, sure. Happy to do that. Yeah, so Platinex is a Canadian-based company in Toronto. We're listed in the Canadian markets under the symbol PTX. We also trade in the U.S. under PAN, P-A-N-X-F. And we've got about a 10 million market cap, and we're focused on developing assets in Ontario and prolific camps. We've had quite a busy year. We made two acquisitions in 22. We started off the year buying a very significant copper nickel project in the Ring of Fire, which is one of the more significant camps in Canada for the production of nickel and copper. And that was just prior to the BHP Wyloo bidding war for Noront. We bought a very similar looking asset and one of the most advanced assets in the camp. And then just last week, we announced a second acquisition, another Inco project. Inco, for your viewers who don't know, was one of the largest producers in copper nickel in Canadian history. And they worked on this project. It's further west of our W2 project. And there was some substantial gold copper nickel results that they drilled. But our focus is going to be confirming the lithium potential, which we believe is a very similar looking deposit as Frontier, which is just south of us.
Mm-hmm. And definitely sounds like it has been an interesting year, essentially bookending the beginning and the end with acquisitions in battery minerals. But let's look at the Muskrat Dam Project. How does this acquisition essentially position the company for success in the new year?
Yeah, sure. No, it's a good question. And what we look for is doing three things with our acquisitions. First, the terms of the acquisition need to be attractive for our shareholders. So we look at buying these projects with very little capital up front. Mm-hmm. Second, these projects all have had significant work done in the past by companies like Inco, majors. So you're buying these projects, for 5-10 cents of the actual amount of money invested in these projects. And the third thing that's very important is the teams we buy these from come join our company. So not only are they selling the project, but they're quite passionate about the projects. They've spent time on the ground with past companies doing the exploration, either with Inco or other juniors. So we're retaining that knowledge so we can really move these projects ahead quite quickly.
And Greg, now that the wheels are in motion for the Muskrat Dam project, what can we expect to see in terms of plans?
Sure. Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, the main reason we acquired the project is not for the other benefits I mentioned previously. But one thing what we're going to do is we're not going to focus on the nickel copper results, which were significant. We're going to focus on confirming the lithium potential. So there's a number of white pegmatites right at surface in the large outcrop. So the plan is to, there had been some drilling and other sampling that had identified the lithium, but this is, several decades ago. So we need to bring that work up to today. So the first thing you'll do is a low-cost sampling program right at surface. And then you'll confirm the grades and where there's clusters of these grades. And then you'd be able to go through a very shallow at-surface drill program to confirm the widths and grades. And I think that'll have a big impact on the share price. And as well at W2, our new copper nickel project, we spent the full year getting the permits to drill it. So we have received those permits. So that'll be a big undertaking, is getting the drills going on that project next year, which I think will deliver significant results to the market and confirm the potential of that project.
Sounds like you're ready to hit the ground running. Thank you for the update, Greg.
Yeah, thank you, Natalie. Happy New Year. Ciao.
And again, the CEO of Platinex, Greg Ferron.